To find out what c needs to equal to make this equation true, we have to modify both sides of the equation so that we get c by itself on one side of the equal sign, and everything else on the other side. Now, to ensure that both sides of the equation actually remain equal to each other, so that we can legally continue to write equal signs in our equation, whatever we do to one side of the equation, we need to do to the other side as well. If these two things start out having the same value, but I, for example, add 4 to the left side and subtract 1 from the right side, then they can't possibly equal one another anymore, since I've changed them in different ways. We'll do plenty of practice with that concept in the coming lessons. For now, though, let's think about what's preventing c from being by itself. We know that we want our final equation to look like c equals blah, 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 something. So that means we need to isolate c, as mathematicians like to say. Instead of having just c, though, we have 92 times c. Remember, there's an invisible multiplication sign right here between our coefficient and our variable. We basically need to undo this multiplication, get rid of it. And the way to undo multiplication is to do some division. Since right now c is being multiplied by 92, to have just c on its own, we need to divide by 92. But that also means, since I'm dividing on one side of the equation, that I also need to divide on the other side. So I also need to divide 598 by 92. Looking at the right side, 92c over 92 is, as we wished, just c. And on the left side, 598 divided by 92 is equal to the number 6.5. Just to be safe, it's always a good idea to check your answer if you know how to. In this case, we can just do substitution. Starting with our initial equation, 598 equals 92c, we can plug in our new value for c and see if this makes a true equation.